Hi, this is Dr. Trace Curry from Cincinnati, Ohio, Medical Director of Metabolic Weight Loss Centers and Journey Light of Cincinnati. Today I'm going to walk you through placement of an Orbera gastric balloon. So here you can see our setup here with the patient on the table sedated. The first step we do is we insert an endoscope into the esophagus and we advance it down into the stomach. We want to take a view of the stomach from top to bottom and just make sure that everything looks okay there. Before we decide to place a balloon. So this is the patient's esophagus and we're just now getting ready to enter the stomach. While we do this, we blow a little bit of air in there so that we can see everything nicely, and the patient is fully sedated so they're not aware of any of this. Here you can see the patient's stomach. We look at the bottom and then we take a look at the top to make sure there's no hiatal hernia or anything like that. And then we just take the scope out while my assistant is getting the balloon ready on the back table. Here's a picture of the inflated and deflated balloon. So I'm just advancing this balloon down into the esophagus now. And we don't do this under direct vision. We just sort of do it by feel and advance it slowly until we're pretty sure it's in the stomach, and then we'll double check that with the scope. So now I'm reinserting the scope, and this time you can see the catheter for the balloon is there. So I'm advancing it down through the esophagus and into the stomach again, and there you can see the balloon itself. And we want to make sure it's just sort of in the middle of the stomach so that we can inflate it and it has plenty of room there. So you'll see my assistant in the background. What she's doing there is she's getting ready to start inflating the balloon while I keep the scope focused on it so we can watch it inflate. And you can see a little bit of saline going in there, and you might notice that it's blue because we put blue dye in the saline so that on the off chance that there is a leak or a rupture, the patient would know it because it would turn their urine blue, so that would be a clue that they would need to give us a call, but that's very uncommon. So the balloon is designed with this little wrapper around it that keeps it rolled up while we insert it into the stomach. And you can see, and you'll see this even better in a few minutes here, you can see that wrapper breaking loose from the balloon, allowing the balloon to inflate. So my assistant is continuing to push 60 cc syringes full of this saline with methylene blue dye into the balloon. And we're going to put a total of 600 cc's of saline in this patient's balloon, which weighs about 1.3 pounds. So my job is just to keep the scope centered on the balloon so we can watch it and make sure it's inflating in the right spot. You wouldn't want it to drift down into the small intestine where there wouldn't be room to fully inflate it. And as you can see, this is what takes up the bulk of the time of the procedure. Here you can see, in this view, you can see that membrane that I was talking about earlier. You can see how that's peeling loose, but it stays attached to the catheter so that when we're finished inflating the balloon, then we can withdraw the catheter and that membrane will come out with the catheter. It does not remain in the stomach or attached to the balloon in any way. So after this procedure, this patient is going to obviously get full earlier because this balloon is taking up a lot of space in the stomach. It's going to roughly occupy, you know, maybe a third to a half of the volume of the stomach, depending on the patient. So when you start to eat, theoretically, you're already maybe half full. So it's going to reduce your portion sizes significantly. But in order to be successful with the gastric balloon, it still relies on eating a healthy diet and exercise. But when you combine all three of those things, the balloon, healthy diet, and exercise, patients will typically lose anywhere from 30 to 50 pounds depending on their starting weight and starting body mass index. So we're just about done now inflating this balloon. You can see that it looks to be fully inflated. And then we just pull the scope back a little bit. And then we tug on that catheter gently. And there's a valve in the balloon that will remain sealed. So we pulled the catheter out and now I'm looking at the balloon freely floating in the stomach. I'll go past the balloon and retroflex the scope back so we can see it and just make sure it looks like it's in good position and there's no evidence of leakage. And in this case, everything looks really great, so this is perfect. So then we just withdraw the scope, and that's it. The patient's been sedated the whole time. The whole procedure took right around 5 minutes, and the patient will wake up quickly and be able to go home probably in 20 or 30 minutes. So again, I'm Dr. Trace Curry from Cincinnati, Ohio. For more information, check out our website at losewaitcincy.com.